This is a planetary gear set. It is widely used in reduction gearbox, also in an automatic transmission of a vehicle. Giving power to one gear, you can get different output from different gears. A basic planetary gearset has four major components. At center, this is the sun gear connected with the input shaft. These four gears are connected with the carrier plate. These are called planet gears because these gears can orbit around the sun gear. This is a ring gear. Ring gear has teeth on the inner side. In a simple gear mesh design, one rotating or driving gear transmits rotational motion to another gear called driven gear. Depending on pitch diameter or teeth number, it rotates at different rotational speed. This driver gear has 12 teeth. And this driven gear has 24 teeth. As linear speed is same at gear teeth contact point, equal number of teeth of both gears will rotate forward at same time. For one complete rotation of driving gear, it will make 12 teeth of driven gear rotate forward. As driven gear has double number of teeth, so its rotational speed will be half the speed of the driving gear. Or you can say, for one complete rotation of driven gear, driver gear has to rotate twice. So the gear ratio is 2 to 1. In this planetary gear set, sun gear has 30 teeth. And each planet gear has 20 teeth. That means, for one complete rotation of sun gear, we'll make the planet gear rotate 30 teeth, but planet gear has only 20 teeth, so planet gear will complete 1.5 rotation. If the carrier is locked, then planet gear linear speed at this gear mating point will make the ring gear rotate forward. Ring gear has 70 teeth. For one complete rotation of sun gear, 30 teeth of ring gear will rotate forward from this mating point. So ring gear will rotate only 154.285 degree. Or we can say for one complete rotation of ring gear, sun gear has to rotate 840 degree. Or 2.33 times rotation. So the gear ratio between ring and sun is 2.33 to 1. Here ring gear rotates in opposite direction of sun gear rotation. When only ring gear is locked, planet gear will be forced to walk around the ring gear in order to rotate by sun gear rotation. This way planet gear's orbiting motion makes the carrier rotate. Let's try to find out the gear ratio of carrier. Let's assume, initially the sun gear rotates 360 degree. Planet gear will walk on ring gear the same number of teeth as sun gear has. Walking 30 teeth of ring gear, among 70 teeth, that makes the carrier rotate only 154.285 degree. But this orbiting motion of planet gear will make the sun gear rotate this additional 154.285 degree. That means, not 360 degree, but 514.285 degree rotation of sun gear will cause the carrier shaft rotate only 154.285 degree. In other words, for one complete rotation of carrier, sun gear has to rotate 1200 degree. So the gear ratio will be approximately 3.33 to 1. You can find the same by applying planetary gear formula. In a planetary gearset, input and output shaft remains in coaxial manner. And here both shaft rotates in the same direction. This is a single-stage planetary setup. By installing another sun gear on the carrier output shaft and adding another planet gear set and ring gear, will further increase the reduction ratio. Now it is a two-stage planetary reduction setup. With same teeth design for both reduction stage, can you guess the gear ratio here between input and final output? Press the like button and write the answer in the comment box. Thank you for watching.